Are passive radiators better than ports and why? I often hear people saying that passive radiators are superior to ports because they eliminate port noises. Since this isn't the whole truth, I decided to make this video about it. The advantages of a port are obvious, it's cheaper than a passive radiator and sometimes easier to implement because it doesn't have a huge diameter. On the other hand, it can also be tough to use a port because it gets too long when reaching a low tuning frequency. This is an issue especially on smaller speakers. The passive radiators doesn't have such issues because it's just like a normal speaker but without the magnet. One thing to watch out for is that also passive radiators sound different. If you plan on using one in your speaker, make sure to use one that still has a voice coil and a spider attached to it because it'll move non-linear otherwise. Most small Bluetooth speakers don't have this and thus causing more distortion by the radiator, which just consists of a weight with the rubber surround. What many people also forget is that passive radiators are basically another driver in your system with other things like distortion, XMAX and especially mechanical losses, which is a big factor when it comes to the sound quality it delivers. If you choose a passive radiator with a bad suspension system and high mechanical losses or too little XMAX for your needs, you'll definitely be better off with a simple port. Maybe one advantage of the passive radiator is that it sometimes, in my experience at least, sounds more precise, because if you have the right passive radiator which has good quality, you know, low mechanical losses and so on, and nice XMAX, it sometimes sounds nicer than a port, as long as the port doesn't have the right tuning. So I would say a perfect passive radiator and a perfect port are nearly equal, especially when it comes to bigger speakers. I don't see a reason not to use a port. It's also cheaper than a passive radiator, but sometimes, especially again if the port isn't tuned exactly the right way, a passive radiator can sound more precise and, I don't know, slightly more on point, but of course it's also more expensive and it's just harder to tune. You know, you have to add some weights and then you have to measure it and you have to make sure it's tight mounted so there's no air coming out and so on. So it's a bigger process than the port, but sometimes it might be worth it. But still, after comparing pros and cons, I would conclude, before using a passive radiator, think of a way to implement a port first, the right way, properly tuned, and if you still need a radiator by that point, make sure to use one that would work as a normal speaker, as a normal good driver, if it had a magnet attached to it, which means, like I already said, low mechanical losses and low distortion and so on. So if you like this video, leave a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel to don't miss out on any future uploads. Also, let me know in the comments what video idea you have or what questions regarding speakers and building speakers you still have. Sometimes I run out of ideas, so you can just let me know what you are interested in. And until then, have a great time and see you in the next one.